Hello children, welcome to the next session. So we are discussing the lesson force. In the previous two sessions, we are discussing about the force only, types of forces, field forces and contact forces. We are discussing in that, continuation of that. Today, we will go continue the topic with the muscular force. So as the title indicates, the force which extends by using our body muscles is known as muscular force. For example, lifting a book, using the pen, duster, rubbing the board, wearing the, whatever it may be, any force used by using our muscles is called as a muscular force. Okay. So, in the first one, look at this. A picture is given. A person is riding a bullock cart. So, brushing, bathing, eating, writing, driving, walking, whatever it may be, its total comes under the category of muscular force. So, ఒక విషయం చెప్పాలంటే without a muscular force, there is no life for a human beings. What does it mean? You may ask, sir, smiling is a muscular force or not? Yes, it is also muscular force. Eating, sir, looking is a muscular force. Yes, eye muscles are looking. If you are staying like this, it's not a force. Okay, so here one activity is given. You have to do that one. Prepare a list of examples for muscular force. So at least 10 activities where you apply muscular force to perform the various tasks in the table. So list of activities to exert force. For example, lowering a basket. Here one is given like this. 10 you have to write. Alright, you are brushing, eating, smiling, exercise, walking, running, writing, sleeping. Sleeping is whenever you are in a relaxed mode, it's not a muscular force. So sleeping is also there. I will move here and there, that is also force means. So it's not a constant one. So go for whenever you are using a muscles, right? So list out that one. Now, activity 6, observing the changes in the muscle while working. So let us see the observations. For example, take a dumbbell and lift in a different ways. For example, this is the first way, and this is the second way, and this is the third way, and this is the fourth way, whatever it is. Observe while doing this exercise, which muscle is going to shorten. So dumbbell means will you use with your teeth, with the legs? Dumbbells means use with the hands. So which one is going to short? Actually this is our hand. So this muscle is going to be short. Right? So ask your friends to do the same and observe the movements of their muscles. So the term muscle refers to the multiple bundles of muscle cells held together. Muscles are normally arranged in such a way that one group of muscle contract and shortens. Another group of muscle relaxes or expands. So, gets shortened and expands. One is get relaxed and another one is expands. Now look at this, for example, if I am doing like this. It is get expanded. Again, get contracted. So like this, some of the muscles will expand, some of the muscles will contract. And some of the muscles will relax and everything like that. So for example, if you throw a ball, the muscle in the chest and the front side of shoulder lengthen to pull the arm forward, while the muscles in the back and rear should hold under contraction to slow down the motion. Right? For example, if you throw a ball, cheyagudu ellipothada ellaga ellipovali kada mari. Now when we are throwing a ball, it is going to extract or extend. Once the action is over, automatically it will come. So where the changes are going to be occur, you have to think. Force is going to apply, which is going to expand and which is going to relax also, we have to check it. That is the observing the muscles. So next one is very important one, force of friction. So friction means, to get the friction definition, just you have to check this one in the next page. Friction is the resistance to the movement of body over the surface of another body. What do you mean by friction is? Friction is the resistance. Resistance means slow down of one body over another body. For example, if you are walking, normally walking, it's okay. If it is a mud one, kuncham soap water unna pade em avutundi velipai shabra velipothama ellaga ade padipothama akade em avutundi normal ga unnappudu baane untundi mara akade em avutundi sharanga okay sir sharanga brake kodtam brake kodnadu tyre kuda motta atu munduku velipothundi mara akade em avutundi nu undochu kada akada takkan kodagana akada ayipochu kada enduku agadu idantha entante observation will get that idea. So, force of friction. When you roll a ball over a level ground, it invariably stops after some time. A level ground, if you throw a ball, it will go to some space, something automatically stop. ఎందుకాకపోతే బాల్ కి నీరసం వచ్చేసారు అన్నది మనం ఎంత ఫోర్స్ అని వేస్తే అంత ఫోర్స్ అని వెళ్ళి కొంచెంసేపు ఆగిపోతుంది వై డస్ ద బాల్ స్టాప్స్ ఈస్ దర్ ఎనీ హిడెన్ ఫోర్స్ విచ్ బ్రింగ్స్ టు ఇట్స్ టు స్టాప్ ఎస్ దర్ ఈస్ వన్ హిడెన్ ఫోర్స్ దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ అస్ ఫ్రిక్షన్ కొంచెం సేపు దూరం అయిపోయిన తర్వాత సార్ మీరు ఇచ్చిన ఎనర్జీ అయిపోయింది సార్ అంటే బాల్ కిట్ట తెలుసు మీకు ఇచ్చిన ఎనర్జీ అయిపోయిందని అక్కడ వరకు వెళ్ళిపోయిన తర్వాత ఆటోమేటికల్ గా ఆగిపోతుంది అసలు ఇక్కడ నుంచే ఆగకుండా వెళ్తుంది ఇక్కడ నుంచే ఫోర్స్ స్టార్ట్ అవుతుంది ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఆగిపోతుంది రెసిస్టెన్స్ బట్ we are given more energy, it will move to some space. So if you stop pedaling of your bicycle on a level road, you will observe that speed will decrease gradually. Cycle ek okasari dokkagane chaavadu ellipodu em avutadi nu dokkina sayap elthadi slope ostadi koncha tokkadam aapestam koncha dooram elthadi ellin tarvata malli em avutadi aagipothadi enduku aagutadi enduku aagali emo sir cycle naaku cycle ishtam nenante cycle ishtam lesa anduke aagipothadu antama dalam kada so is there any force acting on the tents to reduce the speed means yes there is one force acting on bicycle or any momentum any moving body that is nothing but the friction so already this was given that is the friction is the resistance to the movement of a body over the surface of another body so ball is thrown so ball pygesam gravitational force lagutundi మరి కింద కేసిన బాల్ వెళ్ళిపోవాలి కదా బాగా వెళ్ళాలి కదా ఇక్కడ చేసేస్తే సూర్యం వెళ్ళగానే బాగా వెళ్ళిపోవాలి వెళ్ళదు ఎందుకు వెళ్ళదు నీ ఫోర్స్ వరకు వెళుతుంది తర్వాత ఆటోమేటికల్ గా వన్ ఫోర్స్ విల్ స్టాప్ దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ వన్ స్లో అయిపోతుంది ఆటోమేటికల్ గా బాల్ అనేది కొంచెం దూరం వెళ్ళిన తర్వాత ఆటోమేటిక్గా ఎందుకంటే రెసిస్టెన్స్ ద ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఫోర్స్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు రెసిస్ట్ దట్ బాల్ అబ్జర్వింగ్ ద మోషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ బాల్ ఆన్ డిఫరెంట్ సర్ఫేసెస్ హియర్ వన్ యాక్టివిటీ ఈస్ గివెన్ యూ జస్ట్ చెక్ దట్ వన్ ట్రై టు రోల్ ఎ బాల్ ఆన్ డిఫరెంట్ సర్ఫేసెస్ లైక్ కార్పెట్ రఫ్ రోడ్స్ smooth floor see the surfaces of the plane exerted exerted force is same so here three chances given one is carpet rough road and smooth floor endlo baga velthundi easy ga rough road lo baga velthadu sir akkadi ikkada dookunte velthanu smooth floor paina easy ga velipothundi rough roads carpets ema koncham slow ga velthundi so because on which surface does the ball roll further The motion of the ball is different in each case. The force of resistance to the motion seems to be more on the rough surface than the smooth surface. Force of resistance is more on rough surface. So rough surface దగ్గర ఎక్కువ వెళ్ళదు. Smooth surface దగ్గర ఈజీగా వెళ్ళిపోతుంది. So the throwing ball moves further on a smooth marble floor than a rough sandy surface. A smooth marble one, just you throw it, it will automatically goes to there. If you throw it on the sandy part we have to keep push we have to kick go 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 means we have to kick. Why all this one because of this friction only observing the motion of objects on an inclined plane so what is an inclined plane it's an activity a simple activity tray take a tray place a small cube of small ice cube eraser and rupee coin in one line at one end of tray now slowly lift these items in the as shown in figure so take a tray it's a simple one one ice cube one eraser One 1 rupee coin. So just lift the plane. Which will move first? Sorry, razor will roll down. The rupee will stick on. No, the ice cube will move first. Yes, sir. What do you observe? Which one of these three objects slides down first? Why? So do all the objects experience the same resistance to the motion? If not, why? So which one of the objects experience more resistance to the motion? Why? So among these three, first. Ice cube will move fast. Even the rupee coin also move fast. But the eraser is there, na? It may because it will stick to that one. So eraser will stick may stick to the tray. So if you lift ice cube and may chance of 1 rupee may getting fallen, but eraser is little it will go but little bit slow. So what is the reason? Is that this one in the previous case we have taken different type of objects on different surfaces. In this case the surface is same. Objects are different. Ice cube, eraser, rupee coin, right? So do this activity with different objects like book, a ball, a pen, a stone, etc., and record your observations. So like this, we have to observe and we have to note which one is more and which one is less. Now just look at this. Friction is the resistance of the to the movement of the body over the surface of another body. Already I have given. Look at this. One fellow is there, is falling down. పడిపోతున్నాడు మామూలుగా నడవాలి కదా ఎందుకు పడిపోతాం ఒక్కోసారి ఎందుకంటే ఇక్కడ చూడండి Do you ever experience sleeping on the floor? What conditions cause it to you to sleep? Do you experience sleeping while you are walking on a wet mat? Why do most roads accidents happen during rainy days? Why? Rainy days? So rainy days water will be there. Yes. What happens? What happens if water is there? What happens if oil floor is there? So whenever oil if oil is on the spread on the floor, actually the floor will have some friction, resistance. Whenever it's there, it reduces that. So that's why we'll slip and fall down. That is the point. Would it possible to drive a car if there is no friction between the tire and the road? It's not at all possible. There is no friction between tire and road. Can we drive a car? Means we cannot drive this car. So the direction of friction is always opposite direction to the motion of relative surface. Opposite direction. We are moving along with the gravitational force. The friction wheel has to work. Then only we are able to work. If there is no friction, automatically we will skid and will fall down. Let's imagine a work without a friction. Can we walk on a road without friction? Would it be possible to write a pen on a paper or a piece of a chalk on the blackboard? You will learn more about friction in the next chapter. So here, without friction. Friction is different, gravitational force is different. Don't think that one. Friction is the resistance of one surface to another surface, it's one. So without the friction, we can't walk, we can't write, we can't write on the blackboard, anything. Okay. Now think and discuss. A book is placed on the table at its rest. Is the force of friction acting on it or not? So think and discuss. Many times I told, in mathematics and science, never leave this, do this, write this, think and discuss. So what is the point? There is one table and a book is kept on this one. So if friction work out to outunda, outleda. So this is chepal. Then sambandhi explanation is also given. Look at this. So one normal force. So what is the next one? It is given as normal force. The explanation is given here. Force of gravitation and normal force acting on the book. So which forces? Here the friction is not acting. Which one is acting? Normal force is acting. Place your science book on the table. It is in the state of rest. Is there any force acting on the book? Imagine that the table has disappeared suddenly by magic. What will happen then? The book will fall down due to the gravitational pull of earth. So, a table is there, a book is kept on the ground. Book is in rest, no movement is there. Suppose all of a sudden, table is taken off. The book will stay there and it will fall down. It will fall down. It will fall down because of gravitational force. So, pulling is gravitational force. Whenever you are moving, a resistance is a friction force. So beyond this, it's not moving. There is no gravitational force. But which force is acting? Okay. So even when a book is lying on the table, the gravity pulls the book down all the time, but it does not fall down because it is supported by the table. Therefore, there exists a force which supports the book against the gravity by pushing it upward. What we call this force as? So look at the figure. A direction which is perpendicular to the plane of the surface is said to be normal. The force of a solid that surface exerts by any object in the normal direction is called as normal force. So here, friction is not working. Friction is always possible for a moving object. But whenever we are stable, the book is on the table, the earth gravitational force is trying to pull and it was stable. It's not falling down. So what type of force is acting is that, in this case, a normal force. So friction is already over. Next thing is a normal force is acting. Right? So what this direction will be there? It is perpendicular direction to the gravitational force. So a table is there. Now that a book is kept up. Right? So the S gravitational force is acting up. And this normal force is pulling up this one. So that's why the book is at the stable. So here already given. Two arrow marks is given. One is towards the FG. That is gravitational force. And one is upwards towards FN. That is the normal force. So in the above example, downward gravitational force is balanced by the upward normal force. So gravitational force is balanced by the normal force. Since these two forces are equal magnitude and acting in opposite directions, we can say that net force acting on the book is zero and the book is in equilibrium. So what, how much force is acting on the book is zero. Why? Because there are here gravitation force and the normal force, both are equilibrium, both are same acting on the sum. That's why the force will be the zero, right? That's all. So I'll stop at this session today. In the next session, I'll go for tension and next force. Tension and our tension gaadu, vere tension ikkada. In this case, force and tension will be there. So anavasaranga mee tension padakandi. So tension, net force and effects on net force. Total 15 activities are there. We are still in the activity number. Just now, how much completed activity? It is 8, I hope. Activity 8 is completed. Still 7 activities are there. So meanwhile, you can finish the, within 2 or 3 sessions, I'll finish this one. Okay. So that's all. In the today's class, I will explain what is a muscular force and your what type of activities are related to the muscular force. Then after that, I'll explain friction. So what is the friction? And without friction, is there any possible or not? So I will explain. After that, normal force. So that means when any item is in the stable condition, at that type of things, what type of forces will act, and what is the, why it was stable? Because the gravitational force is trying to pull it, and the normal force, normal force is acting to put it. Both the forces are equilibrium, that's why it won't drop or it will be stable, right? So today's assignment is write all the definitions of muscular force, and here it is, list out 10 activities. List out 10 activities. Okay. Next, friction definition and 2 examples. And next one, normal force, 2 examples. Already one example I have given. What is that example? A book on the table. Like this, think, you'll get one more example. So maximum of the students are not writing the homeworks, especially the 8th class boys and 8th class girls also. Some of the students are writing and some of the students are not writing. Don't neglect that one. It's your responsibility to listen the class and write the homework. How much have you given? Just, it's a matter of you just collect the definition from the test book. Hardly 20 minutes. Already the normal muscular force definition is given. List out 10 activities. Already shown in the test book. Friction, definition and 2 examples. Many examples I have explained. Then next, normal force. One example is there, like that you can think one more example. Okay, don't neglect your homeworks. You have to attend the class regularly and finish the given assignment in time. Okay, so hope you understand the concept, and we'll meet in the next session. Bye.